Thanks, Jeff. Joining us now, Nicole Wallace, senior advisor on the McCain campaign, and Robert Gibbs, senior advisor in the Obama campaign. And good morning to you both.
Good morning.
You're just looking at these numbers now, these horse race numbers, the CBS News, New York Times poll with Barack Obama out to a double-digit lead. Let me ask you first, do you wish the election were today or tomorrow, or can you wait 3 weeks?
For a lot of reasons, I wish it was yesterday. I get to go home and see my son. But look, Harry, I don't believe a ton in the overall numbers. Mm-hmm. We don't put a lot of stock in that. We're working hard every day. But I think the most illuminating number, which you see, which is more than 60% of the people think John McCain is more interested in attacking Barack Obama than in talking about what he'd do as president.
All right.
60% of the people think Barack Obama would rather talk about the solutions he has in being president than in attacking John McCain.
Do you wish the election were, 3 months from now? Do you need more time?
We need a little more time, but, you know, I've sat here before in this room, and we've talked about John McCain being down, and we've talked about John McCain being out.
Right.
And I think he said on Monday he's been counted out by opponents before, he's been counted out by the national media before, he's heartened by the fact that Barack Obama and Nancy Pelosi and Harry Reid are planning a liberal democratic takeover of all the levers of government. They're measuring the drapes, and we're fighting for the American people.
All right, here's what is going to happen in this debate last night, because last week there was all this anticipation of a heavyweight fight, a 12-rounder, who's going to win on points, will somebody lay a glove on the other person? It didn't really seem to happen. And the takeaway, especially for independents, was that Barack Obama won. What does your candidate have to do tonight in order to make a difference, especially 3 weeks from now?
No one can out-talk Barack Obama. I mean, he's brilliant. He is absolutely
lowering
the most brilliant
the expectations.
In America. He's the most gifted political communicator of our generation.
Uh-huh.
But I think that what they're looking for is a fighter. And John McCain laid his cards on the table on Monday. He said there's one person in this race who says what he's going to do and does what he's going to say. Mm-hmm. And there's someone else who, you know, lobs untrue attacks against John McCain. The truth is Barack Obama has spent more millions attacking John McCain than any politician, Democrat or Republican, in the history of America.
Sits here silent. Silent.
Well, the talking points are down. But the question is, what John McCain do we get? Do we get the John McCain that we've seen that's erratic in this economic crisis, that's gone from one bad solution to the next?
Both all over your talking
points. Or do we see John McCain that is more interested in personal attacks than he is in talking about how we get this economy moving again and creating jobs for working people?
I'm going to give you Bob Schieffer questions, and I need about a 10 or 15 second answer from both of you. Okay, here's a Bob Schieffer question for tonight. Considering your lack of experience, Barack Obama, how have you been tested that proves you're ready to become president of the United States?
In 25 years of public service, Barack Obama has been tested. He's reached across party lines to work with everybody interested in creating common sense solutions to get things done.
And here's my John McCain, Bob Schieffer question, not that he's going to use these, but you know, that I wish he would. Admittedly, the economy is not your strong suit, Senator McCain. With the economy in the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression, why should we trust you to get us out of this?
We're in more than just an economic downturn. We are in a major national crisis. And in an hour of crisis, John McCain is someone who has actually reached across the aisle, worked with Democrats to take on big entrenched special interests, and has a record of reform that is the best indicator yet that he's the only one that can shake up the broken institutions in Washington and Wall Street.
It ain't over till it's over. We thank you both
for
being
Harry.
With
Thanks
us
for
this morning. We'll be watching the debate with bated breath tonight. Thank you so much.